have an assignment for you. You'll travel to the north, to Lombardy. There's a monastery there, high in the Alps mountains. A few days after Prior Santino passed away, Brother John went missing. Nobody knows where he is. And then, the statue in the main square started to cry. Tears of blood. A miracle. Or is it? Travel there and investigate the situation. The world has no need for false prophecies. Monks who live there will not know we sent you to investigate. I'll inform them of your arrival. But they will think of you as a replacement for Brother John.
Finalmente, we were awaiting your arrival. I trust our journey was pleasant. I will come straight to it. We have been plagued by problems with wolves and other wild animals as of late. Aye, we know who you are. The Cardinal sent a message with word of your impending arrival after you departed from His Grace. We need you to start working immediately. Brother Boris in the greenhouse requires your assistance. Seek him out, and he will tell you what he needs of you.
I have been expecting you. I would like you to help me. Since Brother John disappeared, the garden has fallen into a dire state. I am unable to attend to all of the land by myself. I would like you to tend to the tomatoes today. They are almost entirely frozen. We must protect them, post haste. Also, I would like you to sow some cabbage seeds in this plot of land. I see that you tended to the tomatoes. Do not forget to plant the cabbage seeds as well. Great! You have completed all thy tasks in the garden for now. Do not neglect to deliver some tomatoes to Brother Ezio in the kitchen. Soon, lunch will be served.
Good morrow. Welcome to our humble monastery. Pray tell, do you have any tomatoes for me? Ah, perfect. Thank you. We're not sure. He was at work in the greenhouse as usual, and then he simply disappeared. A Prior Pakal, our new leader, commanded us to put his memory out of our minds. Perchance he traveled to the village below the cliffs, then was attacked by wolves. No, Prior Pakal forbade us from doing so. He thinks it is far too dangerous and the climate too harsh.
He does not want to risk losing another brother. I bid you, what say you of our weeping statue? Never before has such a mysterious happening occurred in this place. Marry, it must be.
You have found me, or at least what remains of my earthly presence. My bones lie beneath this heavy stone plate. After the head of the monastery, our beloved Prior Santino passed away. Prior Pakal became the new prior. In the beginning, all appeared right, but soon I discovered Pakal departing from his quarters in the black of night to wander in silence. I attempted to pursue him. One night, he discovered that I was trailing him. His eyes lit up with rage as they met mine. It was the last sight I ever saw with my mortal eyes. His dagger stopped my breath post-haste. Indeed, he did. He disposed of all evidence and casted my lifeless body into this underground chamber. Only Pakal's eyes witnessed his heinous deed. But he committed one crucial blunder. As he dragged my body to this tomb, a little black pyramid fell from his grasp. It still remains somewhere in this very cavern. No. First, you must finish the investigation of this crime. The whole truth is far more shocking than my murder alone. You must take great care as you explore these areas by moonlight. There is great danger lurking here. Return to thy quarters at once. Sunrise will soon rouse the others. We shall meet again when the time is ripe.
Finally, you're here. I know who you are, and I know your purpose. But soft, we shall not discuss this further in this place. The Templars are patrolling the area. We must not risk them hearing our exchange. Meet me in front of the church at midnight. For the time being, behave as if all is well. Go about your duties as usual, and assist me with the horses. Pakal's horse, in particular, needs care.
Oh, thanks the heavens you're here! I need your help! Church? You shall never be granted entrance. Prior Pacal forbade the Templar Guard to let any man inside. Well, now, if you had his permission, perhaps you could enter. In truth, I know not where Pacal is. But he shall not permit thee to enter the church. Now, will you now provide me aid? Wondrous well. I require assistance preparing the meal for our guests. They arrived early this morning. I have not been informed, but I do need to make sure they do not become hungry or thirsty.
I'm Brother Yuri, the medic. Prior Pacal is himself in the church at present. I am the only other person who he has granted permission to enter the church. No, I cannot do that. An order's an order. My apologies. But hark, is the meal yet served? My appetite grows stronger from moment to moment.
Meet me in front of the church at midnight.
Under the orders of Prior Pakal, the church is sealed to all, only by his hand. The reason does not concern you. Away with you. Back to work. If you do not have any work of your own, you may feed my horse.
Is the meal yet served? I'm very hungry. How wonderful. Thank you.
Forswear! Give me the letter. As you will. You may enter.
Huzzah, you're here. I am Captain Berthold of the Templar Guard. I've been sent here with my men to protect the monastery. I answer to the same man as you, the Cardinal. Prior Pakal requested protection. We were not told more, but we suspect that he possesses a treasure of great value, deserving of such protective measures of the Church. The Cardinal also told me, however, about you and the nature of your investigation. He commanded me to keep watch over you and ensure your safety. Odd events are occurring in this place, and we must be very cautious. Have you discovered the fate of Brother John yet? Swoons, Pakal is a murderer. Are you certain? Such accusations without proof would surely be the end of us both. Very well, then. You should search the church now. Seek out clues that might explain why it was sealed. Perchance you will uncover more evidence. I will remain at this post and keep watch. Have you made any significant discoveries as of yet?
In good sooth, that is the very spear that pierced the flesh of Christ after his crucifixion.
Indeed, such artifacts are scattered throughout monasteries in the land. Very few know their locations. This particular spear was thought to be lost centuries ago.
Until now.
I cannot say why it is here, but it is clear that Pakal kept this top secret. Quick, hand the spear to me. I will see to its care.
Fie, do you not trust me?
Fine, fine, as you like. Hold on to the spear. The spear is your responsibility now. Should it be lost, you will suffer the consequences.
That may be difficult. Perhaps you could travel down the cliff and ask the villagers for aid. Perhaps you could pay a messenger to report thy discovery to the Vatican.
Hey, who goes there? As you will. Proceed with thy obligations. Unhand the book!
Good day.
My name is Brother Leonard. I come to this village every morning because of a little hobby of mine. You see, 'Tis I who crafts and cares for this labyrinth. A small abandoned chapel. Brother Lucian inhabits it at present. Aye, Santino's brother by blood. He has lived in this chapel for decades. He is very old. 'Tis not an easy life for him. That is a lengthy tale. Perchance another time I will tell you. Hark! Could you assist me in finding my tools? Some drunk Templar scattered my tools all around the village.
Good day. We do not have any messengers here. Brother Pakal from the monastery sent these Templar soldiers to keep watch over this area. Nothing's allowed to pass in or out, not even a letter. Young Jarvis, son of Agnes, had a disagreement with the Templars last night. He now fears for his life. I've heard it said that he will attempt to flee from the village tonight. Alack, I've said too much. I cannot tell you that. By now I have said things that should not have reached your ear. But hark, if you assure me that you are trustworthy, perhaps I will guide you to Jarvis. These cursed Templars got drunk last night. Those drunkards scattered all my cabbage across the village. Could you find the cabbage and place it all back into those wooden crates over yonder by the cart? Thank you, stranger. How can I repay you? Indeed. I will tell you now. He lives in Agnes's house, just down the main road. The house has a bronze chantry on the roof. Here, take this bone. You will need it to distract their dog if you want to get inside the house.
I have heard of you. You assisted the innkeeper, is that so? Ours is a small village. News is passed promptly. You seek my son, Jarvis. He struggled with the Templars last night. Perhaps they had a drink or two too many, and it came to blows. Jarvis has always been a quiet boy, an intellectual, an introvert. He's not a hostile boy. He is held up in his quarters, beyond yonder door.
Aye, 'tis I. I know who you are. I was told you are trustworthy. I will help you with thy problem. You have come to ask me to take a letter yonder south, is it not so? I know all, good sir. Aye, I do not plan to stay here even one more day. Since these Templars arrived, I have had no peace. Twice they have beaten me. Yesterday one of them nearly killed me. I narrowly dodged his spear at the last moment. My mother is so plagued by fear that she is unable to sleep at night. It is so, but there is a way. I can make it out through the labyrinth. But there is a problem. The gate to the labyrinth is locked. Indeed. As I said, I know all. I possess a map for the labyrinth, but I do not have the key. That sounds like a good arrangement. But first, help me find my books, and then we will discuss our business. When the Templars attacked me last night, I lost 6 books in the snow while I was running from them.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. I should not permit you to. The Templars would disapprove. But you helped me with my tools. I will make an exception. Here is the gate key. Beware! It is easy to become lost inside. Unhand the book. Well, you may not have it. Now, be gone. Peace. Take the silly book and move along.
Many thanks, good sir. Here, take the labyrinth map. I do not have need for it any longer. I have memorized the whole map. Fear not. You can trust me. Huzzah! Pray, allow me a moment to bid farewell to my mother, and I will be leaving with haste. Thank you, kind sir.
Ah, it is me. I'm so pleased to see you alive. They know you have the spear. My suspicion is that they deeply desire to reclaim possession of it. I heard tale that Pakal instructed the guards to strike first and ask questions later. You must be extra careful now. They are searching the land for you. If they catch you, you perhaps do not wish to hear this, but you will not fare well. You speak like a madman. You should depart from this land at once. Going back to the monastery would be certain suicide. Fine, I will help you. It is your life at risk. There is an underground passage that lies down this dried-up well. It is the only way out of the village. Now, post haste before anyone sees you. Here, take my sword. You may need it. Peace. You had to do what you had to do. Do not delay any further now.
Welcome, stranger. I have. It is very unfortunate. The villagers and Brother Leonard visit me from time to time to keep me company. It is a choice I made, young brother. A long time ago, I fell in love with a girl from the village. As these things often go, she was in love with another man. It happened that this man was my own brother, Santino. We were both young priests, but the beauty of this maiden tempted us like the devil himself. Santino started to visit her in secret. I attempted to warn him that it was the wrong path to follow, but in truth, I myself was jealous. If she would have chosen me, I would have been all too happy to be the one to meet with her in secret instead of Santino. My love for her was greater than my love for my God. I deserved her more than Santino. Victoria, oh, Victoria. Aye, that is she. Santino drew this picture many, many years ago. He kept it his darkest secret. No one except me ever knew of their love. You see, my love was unrequited, and I soon began to hate Santino as well as her. I was determined that this madness had to cease at any cost. I accused her of being a witch. The inquisitors came, a trial was held, and finally, she was burned at the stake. Are you hard of hearing? I committed her body to the fire. I delivered them both to the fate they deserved. They needed to be punished for their sins. Silence! I do not understand why I even told you this. Away with you! Begone! Thy presence interrupts my prayers. I am a murderer. Begone, leave me. You have heard my truth. You have nothing more to torture me with. Leave me. Leave me be.
Stay, thief! Or else what? What say you? Give me the spear or die!
You are nearly there. You are only a few steps away from uncovering one of the darkest secrets this world has ever known. What you will find below this hatch is the ultimate sin, a sacrifice. You see, when Brother Santino passed away, an angel from the heavens traveled down to earth and cried over his dead body. Pakal saw this miracle happen. He remembered the ancient legend that says the blood of an angel can give a mortal eternal life. If a special ritual is performed and an angel presented as a sacrifice to the demons, then the one who did the sacrifice shall be granted eternal life and youth on this earth. Never again will he feel any pain or suffering, or death. Is it even so? When I found out what Pakal was planning, he murdered me. At present, he is planning to murder an angel next. A real angel. Can you even understand what I am telling you? You have to stop this chaos and save the Holy One. You will know when the right time is upon you. Proceed now. The time is nearing.
You cannot save me, brave one. It's too late to save anyone. You need to set me free. Not free of chains. Free me from this mortal shell. Set me free of this body, and I shall rise to the light once again. Kill me. It is the only way. Do not be afraid. You will only destroy the physical form I inhabit. I will be freed from it. No, this is the only way, and you know it.
glad to see you alive. The Cardinal is awaiting.